This video will help you replace your CX sensor flushometer piston. To remove the wall plate, turn the anti-vandal screw clockwise. Slide the wall plate along with the sensor assembly and button. Remove the wall plate. Use the adjustment tool to double check that the activation assembly is turned fully clockwise to ensure the valve is closed. To remove the activation assembly, first vent pressure within the valve by briefly reattaching the solenoid and battery pack to the sensor. Press the button and wait to hear two clicks, then you can disconnect the solenoid. Lift the button up and pull out of the mounts. Disconnect solenoid wire from sensor assembly. Remove the sensor assembly by pulling it off the brackets. Disconnect the battery pack and hardwire connection if necessary. Press the activation assembly into the valve. Squeeze the tabs on the safety collar and pull to remove from the valve. Insert the two provided screws into the activation assembly and pull to remove. Then, remove the piston by pulling it straight out and discard along with spring. To install your new piston, insert the smaller end first and press until fully seated. Install new spring, small end first, into piston. Carefully reinstall the activation assembly and press until fully seated. Now, reinstall the safety collar. Reattach battery pack and solenoid to sensor assembly. Test flush by pressing override button and adjust flow as needed. Attach sensor assembly to the four posts on wall bracket. Be sure not to slide sensor assembly downward. Use the adjustment tool to slowly turn the activation assembly counterclockwise to open the water flow. Reattach the override button by sliding it into the mounts, then flip down into position. Align the wall plate with sensor assembly, sensor, and button. Then, slide the wall plate down along with the aligned parts. Use the Allen wrench provided on the set screw found on the bottom of the wall plate and turn counterclockwise to secure. You've now finished replacing the piston. If you have any questions or comments, please don't hesitate to contact us online at sloan.com/contact-us. One of our technical support associates will be happy to help you out.